How we install an on-premise Moodle LMS, how we go about creating categories in courses, and creating resources within courses. That has been covered so far till date. Today we will be discussing how do we create users in Moodle, what are the different types of user roles and privileges available, and how do you grant the same. Further on in the second half of today's session, we'll also be discussing how to enroll users as teachers and students in courses, and how to connect external databases to Moodle. So that will be the plan for today. So beginning further, is the audio clear?
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, sir.
How are you, ma'am?
Fine, sir. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you very much.
Right. Proceeding further with today's session. First of all, I'll be discussing what are the different user roles available in Moodle, then how do you create users and assign these roles to them. Moodle has certain kinds of users which are available in its system. First and the most important user is called a site administrator. This user is created when you install a Moodle LMS onto your workstation or laptop. So while installation, you created one ID password or a credential set for the site administrator. This is called the super user of Moodle, or the user that has maximum privileges. And this user cannot be deleted from Moodle LMS once created during installation. So site administrators earlier in Moodle legacy systems, beginning from 1.7 to 1.9, there were only one site administrators present. But Moodle 2.2 onwards, there were another flavor of administrators or another type of admins, site administrators that can be created, which are known as managers. So the only difference between managers and admins is that admin is a super user. It is a user that has the maximum privileges and they are created at the time of Moodle installation. But managers are created by system administrators, and their role is to manage who can access a course, modify the course, but they usually do not participate in the course. So you can perceive managers to be one level lower in hierarchy as far as privileges is concerned than system administrators. So moving further.
Ma'am, you people always talk about manager, but you have never shown manager in the your slides or somewhere role in the, yesterday also Uttam Singh, when he showed some graph, he didn't show manager. So what is the use of manager?
That is what I'm discussing, sir. I discussed what are the users of managers. They first, like Uttam sir has given you some credentials for the cloud account, all those who are not able to access the account as
And ma'am, just for another 10 seconds, ma'am, once you have said that admin is the most powerful user, once it is created, it is not deleted.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, yes.
By right. Any means?
Sorry?
By any means?
Yeah.
So if I want to create, delete that user, so what to do? You have to reload this LMS system.
Yes, you have to reinstall. For one installation, the site administrator cannot be deleted.
So once it is created, it is amar. Ye amar ho gaya.
Ji.
Achha. Aur ma'am, dusri cheez ek cheez par last question. Ye jo hum Moodle jo LMS hum kar rahe hain. तो इसको मैं अपने ऑफिस के पीसी पे भी, जो कि पावरफुल पीसी है जिसमें बहुत जीबी हार्ड डिस्क है, बहुत अच्छी रैम है और बहुत अच्छा प्रोसेसर है, उस पर इंस्टॉल करके काम कर सकते हैं हम लोग आगे फर्दर?
बिल्कुल सर।
ठीक है मैम, थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम।
The next type of users available in Moodle are course creators. Course creators are basically intended to add certain material or resources to the course. So a site administrator in a general scenario will be that technical person who will be installing Moodle on Moodle server on your college premise or on your system and hosting it over the cloud network. And he'll be creating certain additional users as teachers, course creators for different courses. Like we've seen a BTEC program. So for every specific specialization of the BTEC program, for every subcategory of the BTEC program, you will need to have a separate course creator because they are departments in their own self. You know, they run with their own processes. They have their own data material and type of activities going on. So course creator is that person who's intended to only add data to a course. And this is the main purpose why course creators are there, to handle courses. They are not bothered about who's enrolled in a course, what privilege to give to other users or not. That is the headache of admins and managers. Then the next type of users that we have are teachers. Teachers are those users who will be assigned with the role of only teaching or uploading material in two types of privileges. One is an editing role and another is a non-editing role. So a teacher has more relevance when it comes to a course. So first of all, let us be very clear that all the users that I'm discussing, these are the different categories of users that you can create in Moodle by assigning certain privilege. But initially, whenever you want to add a user, the process of adding and removing a user will remain the same. First, you will add users, you will create users, even in today's session in the Moodle LMS, and then later going ahead, we are going to attach certain privileges to them. We are going to make a user that we created as a manager. We are going to make a user as course creator. Then we can enroll an existing user as a teacher in a course. That will be discussed by Mr. Uttam Singh Bisht in the second half of the session. So first of all, you are supposed to only create users. Then going further, you can attach roles and privileges to the user. So that is the basic idea. So teachers are those who are going to handle a course, who are going to take up synchronous classes, we are going to call in for assignments, create activities within a course, and they can be in two categories, they can be in two privileges. Either you can have an editing teacher role or you can have a non-editing teacher role. So an editing teacher is one who will be able to change the course content. But a non-editing teacher is one who will not be able to change the course content, who can just view whatever student submissions are coming in, or like a lab assistant, discuss or participate in the discussion posts or forums. So that kind of a teacher is called a non-editing teacher role. So this is the three user roles that we discussed till now: an admin, specialized category with manager, course creator, and teacher. When I'll be walking you through the Moodle LMS today in demonstration, I'll be showing you how these roles are defined. We also have the flexibility of changing the default privilege or role set of these roles as well if you are a site administrator. But if you are working on your cloud account and you have not been able to go through the proper installation process, then probably certain things will be restricted for you. Otherwise, for on-premise installations, we can also change the role set, we can also change the role definition. So that we'll be discussing when we go with the practical implementation of things. The next two type of users are the ones who are going to benefit from the Moodle LMS. They are the actual stakeholders for learning. One are students and another one are guests. So students will be those users who are just supposed to participate in a course, who are supposed to access the resources, conduct all activities which are laid down by the teacher or the course creator, and they are supposed to only participate in a course. They cannot change the content of a course. Their access privilege is very restricted. So students are the main beneficiaries of the Moodle LMS. So we have a scenario where we probably want to add students to our class, then similarly add students to different batches, a morning shift and an evening shift. And this will vary for different semesters and different courses as well within a program. So there are functionalities in Moodle which help you add users in bulk as well. So like if I have 60 students in my class, I'll not be going through the process of creating 60 individual user accounts. There are functionalities for bulk uploads, bulk edits, and bulk deletes, right? So we'll be discussing all of that. Also, there is a specialized functionality or a category called cohorts. So what are cohorts? Cohorts are like logical group of users. If I have, say, 120 students that I enroll in the first year of my MCA program, Out of those 120 students, all will be a part of the first year, right? But from those 120, 60 belong to the morning batch and 60 belong to the evening batch. But the course content for both batches will be same. They will be accessing the same set of resources, the same slides, same lecture material, same assignments. The layout will absolutely be the same. That is how it happens as well in case of real-time teaching learning. When you have two separate batches, they are taught differently with a different set of teachers at different timings, but their examination and resource process remains the same. There is no distinction in that. So for such a kind of a scenario, if I have just one course for which I'm enrolling two batches, how do I differentiate between the batches? The course will be the same. I cannot go on segregating each time out of those 120 students, how many belong to the morning shift, how many belong to the evening shift. So in such a scenario, I'll create cohorts. I'll create a morning cohort and I'll create an evening cohort. So this will logically segregate out things as to these many students are my morning batch. So cohort is nothing but a group of students that have certain logical relevance in a course. So we can create cohorts. We'll be seeing that how we create cohorts, and we can assign bulk privileges in cohorts as well. So all 60 students of morning batch need to access the exam in the morning slot, and all 60 students of the evening batch should be seeing the examination or the quiz activity that I've displayed in the evening slot. So such kind of facilities are also available where you can segregate out activities based on roles or based on cohorts. So we'll see that when we do the practical demonstration. The last category of users is a very restricted category, or I'll say it's a very open access area, that are called guests. So if somebody is not a registered user in Moodle, but is accessing the Moodle site with certain, I'm not saying it's a registered user in Moodle as in they don't have a user account. I'm saying that they're not enrolled in a course as such. So being a user and being enrolled in a course is two separate things. Let's make this very clear. You can be a user, I can allocate you certain roles and privileges, but you can only be a student or a teacher once you enroll in a course. So if you are a guest, you have minimal privileges that you cannot enter any text anywhere. You can just view the content that is available in public privilege to a guest. So this is the least restrictive of all editing privileges, that is the guest account, wherein a user can just access the Moodle site, take in his or her own input, what he or she wants, and not enter any text anywhere. So these are the different categories of users or different user roles. So before we go on to allocating user roles, so in the first half of my lecture, I'm just going to show you how we create users singly in bulk, how we perform single user operation, bulk user operations. Then how do we check for user privileges? How do we assign course creators and managers on the Moodle site? And later on in the second half of the session, Uttam sir will also be telling you how to enroll users as students and teachers in courses. So that is a part of the second half of the session. So just to begin with a practical demonstration, I would request you all those who have an on-premise installation, please start up your XAMPP server and type in the URL on the browser for Moodle and log in using your privilege. And all those who are using the cloud account, please do the same for the cloud version. Confirm in the chat box if you are ready. So, in the best interest of learning, I would request you all to please write your doubts in the chat box once I'm going with the practical demonstration. I have the chat box right there in front of me. So, I'll be answering your queries simultaneously, and then I'll be calling in for doubts when I complete one simple topic or one subtopic demonstration. So, let's begin. So, most of you would have your on-premise installation, so you would be logging in as a site administrator. Rest, all those who have a cloud account would either be logging in as a manager or a post creator, depending upon what privilege Sir has given. Now, every user operation that you want to perform is going to be a part of site administration. It is not going to be a part of site home. Site home will only entail post related and category related operations, but site administration is the section that we are going to deal with today. To create users and allocate privileges. So click on site administration. So once you come to the page of site administration, there are many tabs. So far we have been visiting the courses tab to create courses and categories. To create resources also, first we check whether we have a course created or not. So this is the tab we have been working so far. Today we'll be working on the second tab called users. So all of you would have a users tab, which should probably be second in number on site administration page. On this tab, there are certain options available with you. First option which says is browse list of users. This option is there in the accounts panel. Click on that. So this screen can vary for you and me depending upon if more users are created in your system. This screen will show you a complete listing of all users whose accounts are already present in your system. So when I talk of my system, I have just one account, that is an admin user account. This is my site administrator account, which I created by installing my on-premise Moodle LMS. For you, if you have more than one accounts created, more than one users created in your Moodle system, you will have the listing to be more. So we see here, this page has just a very intuitive search menu. If your user list is very long, you can search using certain filters, contains, doesn't contains, equal to, starts with. So you can do a custom search on your list of users displayed on this page, and all the users which are present inside your Moodle system will appear. So I have just one user, that is my super admin account or the site administrator that I have. Now, if I want to edit certain privileges, edit certain information, this information I added when I created my super user. If I want to edit anything inside this account, I'm able to do here, right? But being the site administrator account, I cannot delete this profile. So go back if you want to change anything. So it happens, you know, at the time of installation, probably you entered something that you later on want to change, or you have not entered complete information, you just entered mandatory fields. Now you want to enter optional fields as well. So you can always edit that account. Now, if I want to create a user, first we are going to see how we create one single user. So there are two ways for it. First way is, in this browse list of users, I have a button down below, this gray button which says add a new user. Let's click here. This will lead to the user addition panel of a single user account. So using this page, when I fill in all this information, this will add one user into my system. If you remember, while creating a site administrator account as well, similar page opened up. So let's choose for a username. Now there are certain rules while creating usernames, is that usernames cannot have capital letters in Moodle. So if you want to create a username, it should not have a caps letter. Let's create a username.
Let's create it as a user 1, 2, 3, 4, just for the sake of simplicity. I hope it will make us more clear.
Choose an authentication method, manual accounts, email based registration, or no login required. So I will say it is a manual account creation. where I will be entering information manually that is required to create a user, right? Generate password.
Tanya ma'am, I'm really very sorry. What are the other options, you know, info like email? I'm so sorry. Email and everything, what do they signify? Email-based self-registration?
Email-based self-registration is, ma'am, that the user will be given a link to register himself on the site. You will not be asking, the system will not be asking you to create all details. The user has to, we say, na, an email has been generated, click on that account link and then confirm all credentials and your account will be created. That is a site, type of email-based registration we are talking here.
Right. Thank you so much, ma'am.
I again request all my participants to please write down the queries in the chat box. Let me complete one section of demonstration because some people are moving with the pace and they get very confused when I revisit the same thing. I will definitely ask you to open your mics in between and ask for questions, but please use the chat box for queries. Thank you. So I say let the account creation be a manual account creation. I want to enter all details myself. I don't want the user to have an email generated where he can click on that email and do a self-registration process. It should be a manual account creation. Now, is it a suspended account? What do you mean by a suspended account? So whenever you confuse with any information on the Moodle page, there is always this question mark sign next to it. Suspended accounts are those wherein a user cannot log in or use web services. Any outgoing messages will be discarded, which means the user will be created in the Moodle site, but will not be able to perform functionalities outside the Moodle site. Like if the user wants to generate an email and shoot an email to the students, that email will not be able to send because he's a suspended account. He is like a disabled account within the system. It exists but suspended from any external action, cannot log in using or use any web services. So a restricted kind of a privilege, or an account is suspended, it is blocked temporarily till the time all the information or the blocking is not removed. Till the time you don't uncheck this box again, the user will not be able to resume his or her operations. So this is for the suspended account. You obviously don't want to create a user as a suspended account or a restricted privilege. You want to create a proper user account giving all information. So the next point is generate password and notify user. So when you click this, first time a dummy password will be generated following all these rules. And upon the first login, the user will have to change the password. But if I say no, I am only the user used to use this ID credential. So I want to set my password for the first time. Then don't click on this checkbox. Click on this link which says press enter to save changes, right? Here there is an visible or a reveal icon, I option. So whatever password you want to type, if you want to see it at the time of typing, you can click on this I. So it will reveal the contents of the text box to you. Then there are certain rules for creating passwords. You see here, it mentions it needs to have at least 8 characters, 1 digit, 1 lowercase, 1 uppercase, 1 alphanumeric value is essential. So I can create a password like admin@123. So all rules are satisfied in this password. If you will click on force password change, then what will happen in this case, automatic password will not be generated because you have specified. But the first time the user logs in, he will be forced to change his password. So I say, I don't want to force password change. I am only the intended user for this account. Then is the case when I am not the intended user for this account. So that case will come probably when you as a teacher are creating your student accounts. So you will be giving a particular dummy password to every student that will have a common pattern, say student name, @ enrollment number. Every time a student logs in for the first time, every student who logs in for the first time is going to change that credential or that password according to his or her own need. So this force password change or generate automatic password and notify users is for that scenario where you are not the intended user of this account. You are creating this user just because you are a super administrator or you have super admin privileges, right? So I say the password is to be admin@123. Now we discussed all these options which have an exclamation mark are necessary and mandatory to be entered. What is the first name of the user? Email address of correspondence. So even if you enter a dummy email address at this point, it is not going to verify or validate. It is just going to check for the format of the email. It is not going to see, okay, if you have written anything like user1@gmail.com, then this is a valid email ID or not. It will just check for the format of the email using a regular expression. That's it. It will not check whether this email ID actually exists or not. So this is up to you. If you make a mistake in the email ID that you enter, then in that case, there is no mechanism to detect whether the email ID was wrong or right. The email will not reach, and then ultimately you have to correct it in the user account. Next, all options here are not compulsory, but we will still see many and set a few. How do you want the email to be displayed? You want to allow only other course members to see my email, hide my email from everyone or from non-privileged users. What type of mechanism do you want? So whenever a user will be created, there will be a user profile that will be created next to the user. And in that user profile, if you want your email address to be displayed to everybody who views your profile, you can change those settings here. You want everyone to see, you want to hide it from people. Whatever be your scenario, you can change it in this section. So I say, allow everyone to see my email address. Don't hide it from anyone. So now this next field, that is the Moodle Net profile. This comes when your Moodle profile, the Moodle site that you installed or created, at the time of installation, you clicked on registration. So if your site is registered with Moodle.org, then you can provide the Moodle Net profile, and it is going to replicate that profile which you registered on Moodle.org and associate it here with this user account. So I have not registered my site, so I will skip this. City, country, all this is optional. I still set country to be India. Time zone is important. Time zone should be your server time zone, that is Asia, Kolkata. Otherwise, the timestamps which come when the user performs certain activity or generates emails or external reports from the system are not going to be consistent. So timestamp is very much important. It should be same as your server time zone. Preferred language, English. Description of the account, if you want to give, it's fine. If you want to skip out all these optional fields, then also it is absolutely fine. Only mandatory fields are required. Once you skip all optional fields and your basic user account is created, then you always have the privilege of editing the user account or the user profile. There you can set in this additional information. So this is the kind of scenario that we do as well. Whenever you will be creating student accounts, you will be just entering basic information. Just additional information or whatever student specific information is there, student will populate on his own. You don't need to fill in all these fields for every student. That is completely optional. Now, if you want to set up a profile picture, then you can do that. If there would have been a current picture, then you could delete it and reset a picture. Next tab is for additional names. If you want to give any alias, that is just for the profile name. The user account, the ID password that you're creating will be unique. The profile name that you are providing for that, if you want to provide any alias, you can do that here. Interest, if I want to add any hashtags or associate tags related to interest that this person is hashtag baseball player. So all those baseball players in my Moodle.org, in my site, will link using this hashtag. Optional information, if you want other information, mobile, address, department, other email account, then you can fill this. I will skip this and simply click on create user. Now you see here, this leads me back to my browse list of users. From here only, I created a new user using add a new user. So this is the user account that I create, user one account. Now, if you see here, the account above, the site administrator, you don't have these two icons, the enable disable option hide or show, as we say, and the delete option. So that is why I'm saying the site administrator cannot be deleted. Yes, once created, needs to be the same and can only edit certain information in his profile for the entire Moodle installation. But when I talk of a user account, I have the privilege of either suspending an account. So if you would have clicked on that suspend account checkbox, this user account would have come hidden. You can do that same thing here as well. After creation, so see, it comes almost disabled. So you can suspend and revoke this account. You can also delete this account. If I am a super administrator or if I'm a site administrator and I've created an account, I can always delete and edit it as well. So this is how you create a single user, one user into a Moodle system. Now I like to invite queries. If anyone is facing a problem, please unmute yourself and please let me know till this point if anyone could not walk through me. And if you are able to
Your voice is breaking.
I cannot hear
just
you.
Hello, Tanya ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, in the last, when we are on this screen, two users, new filter, it is written. So, you in the last few sentences you have said, but I couldn't hear them properly. You have said one sentence is that you have in the new user you have two or more icons, but in admin user you don't have these icons.
Yeah.
So after that you have said two or three lines. So can you repeat them, please?
Okay, sir. So what I said is that when you are a site administrator, you can't, or even if you are not logging in from the site administrator account.
Ma'am, just hold on. The site administrator or admin user is the same thing.
Yes, sir.
So, matlab, we should not confuse on this.
Okay, right.
So, matlab, that means that site administration is the
site administrator. Administration is the panel, sir, where the site administrator performs his or her operations, whatever. Okay. Right?
So, and that
site
that,
admin or a site administrator, these two terms are the same.
And these site administration, performance can be done only by admin user.
I'll come to that when I talk of roles. Right now I'm just demonstrating user creation. Then I will tell you what different roles have what privileges.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Hello, Tanya madam.
Yes, sir.
I want to add the multiple user at a time. How can it possible?
Sorry?
Multiple user.
Yeah,
at a
that
time.
Is the part of my further session. I have just created one user account and I'm asking if anybody has a problem till this point. I will proceed and show bulk operations. That is a part of
the process. Okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the MoodleNet profile that you were saying?
MoodleNet profile is while installation, there came an option that register your Moodle site. Uttam sir might have shared that step with you. So that point, if you would have registered your Moodle site with moodle.org, then a MoodleNet profile would have been created. So that text box while user creation was referring to the same MoodleNet profile if your site is registered. If your site is not registered, then it's fine. You don't have a profile, you don't need to mention it also. It's optional.
Okay, thank you.
Tanya ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, when we are visiting the Moodle on cloud that sponsor has made, I am able to see number of users which he might have created.
Right.
So what type of users are we? Like I can see here many names that are common. So what type of users are we in this account?
To my best knowledge, ma'am, you would have been managers. Rest, I will just confirm once for them, sir. What privilege has he given to you? But
Dr. Tanya.
Yeah.
Dr. Tanya, I want to know what is the purpose, what is the meaning of user here? Are we creating these users for my students or like what? Like I'm teaching a course. So these users are the student that I'm creating
That is what I mentioned when I discussed the theory portion as well, sir, that first of all, we create only users. Users are those people who will be accessing your site. That's it. Then in what privilege will that be accessing your site? What role they will access your site in, either as teachers or students, will come from this user list only. So even if you talk of a teacher or a student, initially it is a user. Then you give it a privilege or a role of a teacher or a student.
Okay, so you as a site administrator, you are actually giving different users, which who may be faculty also, who may be course coordinator also, or who may be student also.
Absolutely, okay, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
I'll also create more managers or site administrators.
Yeah, Tanya, I think you have read my question.
Yeah,
as my voice is breaking, I have posted. Right. I missed first 5 minutes. Just show me from where you started.
This would be your landing page.
Yeah, yeah.
Dashboard. Site administration.
Yeah.
Users, the second tab.
Yeah.
I'm at the first option, browse list of users.
Okay.
So here, whatever users were created in my system, I can see their names and their operations. With these users, if I want to create a new user, I clicked on this button, add a new user. So whatever user management.
So you were using this box, add a new user. Yeah. You were discussing about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was at browse profile, browse list of users, and from there I created a user, added. So whatever user-related operations we'll be doing in site administration only and under the users tab.
Okay, thank you.
Any other question?
So ma'am, now I can go to edit and whatever edit field allow me to addition, I can do some addition there.
Yes, sir. If I click on edit here, so all the information that I entered, if I want to change it, or all the information that I missed, if I want to add it now, I can do that and update my profile.
See, at any time.
Update profile. Yes, at any time.
So there is no restriction on this.
No.
Dr. Kane, I have one more question.
Please, sir.
Like for this course that we are enrolled, we are the one who are enrolling. So there you as a faculty has enrolled us, or we ourselves have enrolled us?
Again, so that is a different thing. When you talk of course enrollment, that is a separate part. You create users, okay, like assign them privilege, and then you enroll them to a course. There are three steps. So the first two steps I will take up in this session, and the course enrollment will be in Uttam sir's session.
Okay, thank you, madam.
Go back to the users tab on site administration. So we saw the first option here, browse list of users. From there, we added a user. If you want to directly add a user, you see this third option here, which says add a new user. The third option in users tab account section, which says add a new user. Click on this and the same page will appear to add a user. So you can add a user using two ways. First of all, browse list of users. There you have the add users option. And the next option is present on users tab, account section, add a new user, the third option. So using both these ways, you can add a user. So let us add another user. Same steps I'm following. I've just given the username. I've set up the password. following these rules. I've set up a manual account, so I'm not asking for any email-based registration or I'm not changing password. Giving him the username, first name, surname, and email address. Rest, I don't want to set any other information. Time zone is perfectly fine. It is the server time zone. And I simply say create user. So now I have three users in my account. User 1, user 2, and the site administrator. Now I will discuss bulk user uploads. So in site administration, users tab. See the second option here, bulk user actions. Let's click on this. This leads you to a page where you can see what all users are present inside your system and what operations do you want to do. You want to add users to, you want to probably delete a group of users, you want to send a message or an email to all those users, you want to display or force password change for all these particular users. So all bulk user operations are possible in this section, which says bulk user actions. So in my account, I have three users on my Moodle site, admin user, user 1, and user 2. So whenever it will talk of bulk operations, it will first ask you to have bulk selects, either select two or more user accounts, put it into the selected section, and from the selected section, you can perform operations. You can confirm the user creation, send a message to all these users on their email IDs, delete these users, force password change, or add to cohort. So these are certain bulk user operations that I want to do. But if you see here, I don't have too many users. I've just created three users. So now if I want to create 60 users, will I go about that mechanism where I will simply add one and one user using that big page, I have to fill in information, make sure passwords are in place and everything. I can't do that operation for 60 students. And especially for a complete program, it is impossible. For close to 300, 400 students, if I go on to creating single user accounts. So before we do bulk user actions, how do we add bulk users? Go back to site administration. Under users tab, you see the second last option here, upload users. Click on this. So now whenever you are supposed to upload or add bulk users, the information will come from an external source. It will come from a file. There will be some file on your system that will be having the information of all users that you want to add. So like you have a complete listing of students enrolled in your course, either from your student information system or you have your manual uploads at the time of admission. So you have a complete student list that has name of student, email ID of student, and certain additional information. Why not as well modify the sheet in a particular format and upload it to the system as it is? Why create single accounts? So what type of fields are required? What format is required for adding bulk users in a system? So on this upload users page, you see there is a sample text file which says example.csv. When you click on this file, there is a CSV file that gets downloaded, right? So a CSV file or a comma separated values file is basically a simple file. It is a .csv extension file wherein data is present separated with commas. So all rows, there'll be multiple rows pertaining to multiple entries, and column values will be separated by commas. And since most of us know CSV files are compliant with Excel files, they open up as Excel files. So just click on this example.csv. So this file I have not created. This file I have simply downloaded from the Moodle site. Moodle will tell me what information I require in what format in order to create bulk users. So it says this first row here, user name, first name, last name, and email. These are the only mandatory fields, if you remember, while user creation. While we were creating users so far, there were certain fields which are essential, which were marked with an exclamation sign. And there were certain fields which were optional, not marked with an exclamation sign. So these were my essential fields. I had to have a username, and these were my important or essential fields, first name, last name, and email. If you don't give these information, yes, if you don't give this information, your users cannot be created. Passwords here, sir, is optional, because even if you don't specify password, system can always auto-generate a password and send it to the registered email ID. So if you remember, while creating password, we had the option that you want to auto-generate password or you want to type in the password in a given format. So this information says, this file says no need to give password. I will generate an automatic password, a system-generated password in the specified format, and I will notify the student on email. Student will get an email to this ID that you have mentioned here. Clicking on that password, entering that detail, student can always change during the first run, right? And even if you want to have certain other functionality, like you want to force password change or you want to perform, add certain additional information, that also we'll see. Once we upload this file, there will be another screen that comes up. So in this file, be very sure that the first row, username, first name, and email, this information is the column header. You cannot change this information. If you take this information off, Moodle will be confused. You know, it will not be able to identify what the column means. So we will start editing from this row onwards, second row onwards. I have already created two users. I'll create three more users. And see here, one more thing before I start creating the users. Username is all small caps. There is no capital letter. So as I said, you know, there is no capital letter that you can give in username. Say create another user. First name, last name can have capital letters. Please download this file simultaneously and you also create your users. So Nancy ma'am, if the student forgets the password, then even when you log into your Moodle site, there is an option that comes forgot password or regenerate password. So up on the email registered, on the registered email ID, there will be a password reset link that will go. So student can always change his password if he forgets.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir, it is email-based registration. Please create three more users in this file, user 3, user 4, and user 5. And you can change the information, you can give legitimate names, you can give different email IDs, or you can use my format. Anything is allowed, both are fine. If you have downloaded this file and you were able to populate the fields according to your choice, please confirm in the chat box. Then only I will move to the next screen. Meanwhile, all those who have questions or are facing problems, please unmute yourself and ask.
Ma'am, can you please repeat from where you will get this file?
Sure, ma'am. Were you at the screen, ma'am? Upload users that we were discussing?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you see this file here, example.csv? Does it come on your screen?
No.
Are you on upload users, ma'am? Site administration upload users?
No. Okay, you are on VVI cam learning model. Okay.
Go to site administration users and this option, second last option, upload users. Please confirm in the chat box. Got it, ma'am?
Yeah.
Okay. So please confirm in the chat box if you were able to complete your Excel file.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
There are two keywords, CSV delimiter and encoding. What does it mean?
Please wait, ma'am. I'll upload the file and I'll share. That's the latest step. First, I'm waiting for participants to be with me till this point. Okay, so close this file. Just be very sure where you have saved this file. Now, the file that you have just created, either drag that file into this box and upload it, or choose a file. Click on choose a file, upload a file, choose file. This will open a file picker. Move to the location where your file is stored, open it, and upload the file. Your file name would be coming in this box. Upload the CSV file that you have just created.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, can you just hold for a second? Because I have just changed the name of the file, that user 123 in my file. Okay. So after that, what to do?
You have created the file, right?
User 1, user 2, user 3.
Yeah. So move back to your Moodle site. This will be your page.
I have to save this file, na?
Save any location, sir. You save it on your desktop, save it in a drive. You have to just pick it up from that location. Save on desktop is fine.
Save. Okay, ma'am, saved it.
Right, sir. You were here with us on upload user section.
Just a minute. Let me see. Yeah. Upload users. Upload, yes.
So click on choose a file.
Yes, ma'am, choose a file.
This option, fourth number, upload a file.
Upload a file.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then this choose file button next to attachment.
Where, ma'am? Just
a minute. This one, sir, choose file. This is a button, na?
Acha, this box.
Yeah. Did this window open for you?
Yes.
Yeah. So now move to desktop.
Okay. I don't know where my file is saved.
Here, sir. I'll tell you. See, on your left panel, you will have a lot of options coming up here, right?
Okay.
So with this option of desktop, click on desktop.
Desktop, yes.
Right. So you will be able to find your file here. Type the file name if you don't find. Otherwise, you'll be able to see your example.csv here.
Which one, ma'am? Example dot?
CSV, example. That is the name of the file, right, sir?
No, I'm not getting. So what to do? I have to type this file, example dot.
Yeah, you type here. If you're not getting, then you type example.
Where?
This file name box.
EXAMPLE, example dot?
CSV.
CSV. And say open.
Yes.
Example.csv file not found.
On the desktop, sir? Did you save successfully on desktop? Can you share a screenshot on WhatsApp of where you are? Just share a screenshot of your desktop.
What did you say, ma'am?
I'm saying, sir, on the WhatsApp group, please share a screenshot of your desktop. So, like from your mobile, take a picture of the desktop and upload it on this WhatsApp group. I'll see it there.
Okay, ma'am, just hold on. Send it.
Yeah, so the file is not in your desktop. Probably it is in your downloads.
Well, ma'am, but I also tried from this PC. So this it should come from this way, na? This PC. It should say download is also in this PC. No, let me find out in download.
If it's in your downloads folder, you can see from there. Because by default, it gets downloaded to the download folder. If you're not setting up.
Yes, ma'am, it is in download folder.
Right, sir. So we'll now do choose file, upload file, choose a file. Now move to downloads. Like you saw desktop here on the left panel, click on downloads. You'll find your CSV file.
I did it, ma'am. This file has come. Example.csv is available against choose file.
Perfect, sir. Were you able to see this file, this name here in this box? Were you able to upload it?
No, I am not able to see this name.
Okay, sir. We'll do once again. Choose a file. Click on choose a file.
No, ma'am. This example.csv is coming after choose file. So now I have to say upload this file.
Yes, sir. When you choose a file, it just gets opened or linked to that box. If you have to upload it, click on upload.
So now it is coming. Example.csv is coming in the column.
Okay, sir. Perfect.
I'm sorry. I just wasted your time.
No, sir. All learners are important. Okay. So we are here at the same page. Everybody, we are able to upload a file. Now the next three options which say First one is a CSV delimiter. Now, a CSV file or a comma separated values file is basically a file that is going to separate the row values pertaining to different columns using a comma. Now, if your CSV file is not delimiting column values with a comma, it is using any other delimiter, say a semicolon, a colon, or a slash t, a backslash t. If these characters are, if you're using as delimiters, then you will select this delimiter option from here. But we have not changed the CSV format. We have just opened the CSV file into its current form. That's why it opens up into an Excel sheet. Otherwise, if you want to see, this was your example.csv, right click, edit with Notepad++ or Notepad, edit with Notepad. You'll see here, this is the file, your example.csv. Just a minute. Is the screen being shared?
We can't see you.
Yeah. I'll just share your my screen. Just a minute. So what did I do? I right click on this file, example.csv. This is where I saved it. Right click this file, and I say open with Notepad. Right. Right click. Open with Notepad. So this Notepad window opens up, and this is my CSV file actually. So if we were directly clicking it and opening the CSV file, it was opening into an Excel sheet. But if we right click and edit with Notepad, you'll see all column values are separated using a comma. That is why it is called comma separated values. So you can change this comma to any other delimiter. This comma is called the delimiter, which delimits values.
Ma'am, on right clicking, I'm not getting this open with Notepad. I'm on this clicking, it's saying...
Right click, sir. Open with this option you come. See here, open with.
This is saying only open link in new tab, open link in new window, open link in into going window, send link to other device, save as link, copy to link, but these are the coming.
No Never coming. Mind, sir. If you're not able to see it as an CSV file, there will be no problem. I'm just telling that how do we change the delimiter? Even if you just open it as an Excel sheet and we change the values in Excel sheet, that is also fine. I'm just giving additional knowledge. It's not required for this operation.
But why, ma'am, it is not coming in my computer, because the latest everything...
Sir, you have to go to your downloads and then you have to right click.
Okay.
Okay, so if we see here, the file has all the values. Open with Notepad. All values are comma separated. That's why it's called a comma separated file. Now you can change this delimiter, that is the comma, to any other value also. It can be a colon or a semicolon. Both options are available, right? Or backslash t. Then you have to do it unanimously for throughout the file. Like I say, a colon here, and every colon will be changed this way. So you cannot change the column name. Column headers have to appear first. The first name, last name, username, this has to be the first row. This will actually tell that the values coming below, what do they signify? The first value will always be username. Second value will be first name. Then account will be my last name. And the last value is my email ID. So you can't change the column name. You can change second row onwards any value.
Ma'am, my screen is not coming now.
Oh, sorry. Now, sir?
Yes.
Right?
So, ma'am, you are telling that there is no, we should not change the separator.
No need.
You are just telling the example how to change it.
Yes, exactly.
So if I am not done, then there is no problem.
No problem. If you are able to upload CSV file, it's perfectly fine.
That is CSV file is uploaded in that uploaded area and it is written there.
Bas, sir. Perfect. I'll just move back to that section.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. So nice of you.
Thank you, sir. Okay, so this was the delimiter that I was talking about, CSV delimiter. So it says here, if it is any other delimiter in the file, you can set it. So I'm not going to change this delimiter. I'm not going to change my CSV file. I'm going to open it as an Excel and only add value. I don't want to get into extra technicalities. Encoding, UTF-8 encoding is basically a character encoding. of the characters present inside the CSV file, encoding format basically. That is, there are many other formats, ASCII, UTF-16, many other. So you don't change this one also. Let the default encoding format be UTF-8. Then it says preview rows 10. If your file has more than 10 rows, then when you will be uploading users, at the time only first 10 rows contained will be displayed. If you want to increase this, you can always change the preview rows option. Okay, don't change anything in these three options. Simply, you have to upload a CSV file in this page. That is all that you have to do. You have to change or add content in the CSV file and upload it. And say, upload users. Now, this will directly not let upload users add as it is. It will leave you to a preview page. It will first ask you to add only basic information in the Excel sheet. Then if you want to have certain additional settings for the bulk upload, like I say, add only new and skip existing users. What should be the upload type? You want to add new, skip existing, or add all and append numbers to username. If there is already a user present in my Moodle site and I'm trying to re-add it, then in that case, what should be? I want to append it, I want to update existing users only, or I want to skip the similar users. So all the writing operation in case of same usernames being added again and again, you want to overwrite, you want to skip it. If you want to specify any of those that information, you can do that in this setting. Then see the password thing that most of you were asking. New password for the user. How do you want the user to create a password? Because in the CSV file, I have not specified passwords. That was not required. So how do you need to specify? I say it will be a field required in the file. So if I want to explicitly specify passwords, I can have another column next to email called passwords in the file and write all passwords. But I don't want to do that. So I say create passwords if needed and send via email. This is that option that which we saw. Generate automatic password and send for email registration. So if I select this option, it will not look for password field in my file. And by default also, you see the value will be automatic password creation because it did not find the password field in your Excel file that it passed, right? So let it create a password and send by an email. Student will view the password and it can change on first login. Standardized usernames, yes. The same username, caps, everything that you're using will be same. You'll not be able to change the capital or small font in the username later on. Select for bulk user actions. All users, no users, or updated users. Now this field specifies that I showed you the bulk user screen just before upload. So do you want all users to by default be selected for bulk user operations? Not needed. I will select when I want to perform bulk actions. Why you want to put all users in that field? Where bulk operations, whatever bulk operations if a user performs, will be done on all users. Don't do it. Do it only when required. Select it as no. Then email display. How do you want the email to be displayed to other course members? Whether you want to show your email, you want to hide your email, whatever. Auto subscribe. Now, if there are any posts from this Moodle LMS that the user will be registering for, those posts should come. You want to subscribe to those discussions or you don't want to subscribe to those discussions. You know, sometimes you have this functionality of generating email alerts or generating notifications and sending to all users. So you want all users to view it or not view it. Option is there with you. So you say, okay, let us subscribe. Just all this is optional. So if this information you're not filling, it will only create users with basic information. Extended information, a user can always change and edit when he accesses his account. Say upload users directly. Now it will say, okay, users were uploaded. There was a success in uploading. Three users were created. Users having weak password, zero, because we didn't generate a password for users. It will be automatically generated. So that will be a strong password, system generated, and no errors. If any error comes in the upload process, it means you have not specified something in the Excel file as it should be. You have changed the format of some cell value. So please check your Excel file. It will give you a detail of what the problem is. Say continue. It will lead you to the same tab, upload users. Now, if I want to view, where were my users created? Site administration, users, browse list of users. See here. Now I have furthermore three email accounts that were created. User 2, I created manually. After user 2, user 3, user 4, and user 5. These I uploaded from my file. So these also come in my browse user list. Are we able to do up till this point? Please confirm in the chat box. If you want to add more information to the Excel file, then to the user upload, then you have to add more columns to your Excel file. Like if you want to write password, then you have to have another column called password after email ID and then specify the passwords. Similarly, if you want more information, you give it in the Excel file. Necessary is only this much. Compulsory is only this much. Okay. So now we move back to site administration. Users, you were able to browse users, create a user, single user, and create multiple users. What if we want to delete users? It is also a scenario that sometimes you would have created a wrong user or a user that should not be there in the system, or a student that who has left the college. We want the credentials to be revoked. How do we delete a user? There are two ways to do that. One is again a single user delete option, and another is a bulk operation. So first I'll talk about the single user operation. In the browse list of users panel, where I see listing of all my users, there is this option to delete a user. So if you see, this is delete option available with all users except the system administrator or the site administrator. So you click on delete. It will ask you for confirmation. Are you absolutely sure you want to delete the user? I say, yes, I am sure I want to delete user 5. So now my system has only 5 users. So this is how you can one by one delete users in this user panel. Password will be created and will be sent, ma'am. There is no way you can ensure that. You have to wait for an email. That is it. It will be an auto-generated email that will be sent. The Moodle LMS will do that for you. Okay, so this is how you can delete users one by one. Like if I want to delete a user that I've created by mistake, or if one student has left my course, gone in for some other program, then I can delete users using a single user delete option. From browse list of users, there is a delete option which is present ahead of all users. Go back to site administration, users tab. Second option, bulk user actions. Now, if you want to perform certain bulk user actions, how to do that? You have a list of all users displayed in the left panel. If you want to perform certain bulk options, bulk means a lot many accounts, you want to perform the same option. So select a user account and say add to selection. So when you click on this add to selection, the user account goes to the selected panel. Click on another user account, again say add to selection. So now I have two users accounts that I selected. if by mistake I have entered an account in selection and I want to remove that account, I don't want to perform bulk operation on this account, select the account and say remove from selection. So this will transfer the account from the right panel to the left panel. So this is how you can add or remove single user account to selection and from selection. This is the selection panel, the one on the right. These are your available accounts on the left. Selection panel is the one on the right, right? And if you want to select all user accounts at once in one go, then you say add all. So this is going to add all user accounts to your selection, right? Now, whatever accounts are present inside this right panel, if you want to perform certain bulk operations, that can be done. How do you do it? With selected users, do what? Send a message, delete, download, force password, change, or add to cohort. So whatever you want to do, whatever bulk operation you want to perform, if you want to delete all users, if I want to delete all users from the system, click on this option delete. So this is very sensitive. I'm just showing you how this is available. I'm not going to perform this. Otherwise, I have to create users again, right? So you can perform bulk operations upon multiple user accounts at the same time. Rather than deleting everyone singly, I can simply add them to a selection and say, with selected accounts, delete or confirm or force password change or add to cohort, right? So these are bulk operations that you can perform on user accounts that are created in your system, right?
Ma'am, when we selected that all selection, this admin user also copied in the right hand side.
Yes,
so,
sir.
When we press all delete all users, so this user will not be deleted.
It won't be. It will not let you delete the admin user. And I'll suggest let's not try that, sir. Otherwise, you'll have to create all user accounts. You can probably just add admin user to selection and try that.
I couldn't get you. Can you come again, please?
I'm saying.
First of all, when I say all users, so this copied from left hand side to right side, all users. Including admin users.
Got it. Just a
and
minute.
Now,
I have just selected my admin user. This is what I'm saying, right? We have a query just regarding this. Now you try to delete. Then you will do this. This is what I'm saying you should not do, because this will create a lot of problems for you. You know, it will create a lot of restrictions and it's not feasible. But if you want to see what happens, then just select admin in selection and perform this. But again, not suggested. Until and unless you don't have a manager or any other person, you know, of a similar privilege, let's not do it with the admin user. Probably we can create a manager and then try and delete the manager. That we can see, that will be possible, but not with the site administrator.
Ma'am, this is what I'm saying, that I have a list of users in this my panel of users. And fortunately or unfortunately, admin user will be there. Okay. And when I say add users, select all users, so it will be copied to right panel.
Absolutely.
And when by mistake I say delete, so they will delete all users except admin user, or whether admin user also be deleted.
Admin user cannot be modified or deleted, sir.
So if I will, when after the class, if I will try that delete all the users, so it will delete my rest of the users and admin will be here.
You're talking of trying, even if I ask you to try, will lead you to, you know, have a lot of problems and probably do the installation again. So I don't want to suggest it to you.
No, ma'am, because that you have to answer, because I have to look after this. This is a very...
This is never a use case that we want to delete the admin user. You are trying to delete the base of your system. Why would you ever want to do that? He is managing people.
This admin user is up to me. So no student can try this.
No way. Not at all.
Not at all. That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So this is something.
There is a problem.
May it is something like that you are blocking your main gate. Your...
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. So, ma'am, how long will this class will go on before practice session?
This is the practice session only, sir, that we are doing side by side, but I intend to wrap up by 3:30.
Will you speak about cohort? How to add?
I have not started cohort, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, there is some problem coming. May I be permitted to ask?
Sure, ma'am, please.
Thank you so much. It's coming, an error occurred while loading the CSV file, invalid CSV file format. Number of columns is not constant. More information about this error. And then there is an option. Moment I continue, this message pops up.
So have you entered values for some columns in particular rows and missed those columns in some other rows?
I have just used that example file. And using student, I have used this user word. I have eliminated this word student, and instead of student, I have used user word. That is it. And then obviously, rather than using 1, 2, 3, I have gone for 3, 4, 5, like tried to duplicate whatever you have done. But this query is coming, an error occurred by loading the CSV file, invalid CSV file format. Number of columns is not constant.
Okay, ma'am. So in that case, I'll request you to please email your CSV file to me. I'm specifying my email address in the chat box. After the session or towards the end, I will look into your CSV file, your Excel file, what mistake are you doing, and then we'll coordinate towards the end of it.
Not a problem. Right.
I mentioned my email ID. You can mail me.
I have put it down. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so let's continue with the demonstration.
Ma'am, just it is an out of box question that we in assignments you have been asked to write down something what you have learned in this session.
We
write down that we have learned the user creation, user deletion, or something like that.
Absolutely, this is whatever we are teaching, that only you have to write. So if we are teaching you user creation, your administration, you will write that. But then there is also a column, how do you implement it or how do you plan to use it in your organization? There you can give an innovative answer.
And what is the outcome of these three outcomes? User one is better, creation is better, or this or this.
Yeah, we'll discuss that. I'll connect the person who's responsible for assignments with you. So you can always get your queries resolved. And she's on a WhatsApp group also. So I'll connect you with ma'am for that.
Not right now, please.
Not right now, absolutely. I want to complete my session.
Please.
Sure. Okay, so moving back to site administration. Users. Now we have seen bulk operations, addition, and single user addition and deletion. We've seen that, right? Now the next thing is cohorts. Click on this option. Cohorts, I told you, if I want to add a logical grouping to users, if I want to create a logical group of users, say morning batch, say evening batch, then I will add cohorts or create cohorts. So right now in my system, there are no cohorts. This section is coming empty. What if I want to add a cohort? What if I want to create a cohort? So there are two options. First is you add a cohort, you create cohort details, and then you add students to the cohort. That is possible using this third tab, add new cohort. But then there is also an option in the end, which is upload cohorts. So this option will ask you to upload a group of users in a CSV file, in a file format. And that group of users will belong to one cohort. So these two options vary. Like in add a new cohort, you are creating a folder, and later on in that folder, you are adding users or adding content. So for that, we add a cohort and then we'll add or subscribe users to that cohort. And the other option is uploading a cohort, which means you're creating a folder and at the same time, you're uploading contents in the folder. So you're uploading multiple contents which get uploaded in a cohort or a complete logical package. So we will be seeing how we create a cohort and then add users to the cohort. I say the name of my cohort is morning cohort. which means morning batch. Right? Context, you want this cohort to exist at the system level or at any specific category level. You can specify. So I say, let this cohort exist at the system level. You can also make it specific to a category that this cohort only has relevance to the BTech program. For an MBA program, there will be a separate cohort. ID, if you want to give a unique ID, whatever ID format you want, say batch ID, like we have, you know, a batch or program IDs. For a morning batch, we have 116 as a unique ID, the institute ID. Then for an evening batch, we have 353. So if you want to specify that kind of an ID, you can do that here. Otherwise, this is optional. Description is again optional. Simply save changes. So this way you see, it's a morning cohort which is added, and description I have not given, ID I have not mentioned. Size of the cohort is zero because I have not added participants or users to this cohort, and I've created this cohort manually. If you want to change, edit, delete, or suspend the cohort, you have these three icons which are same as it works for users. Last option, if you see, is assign, this people icon. Just click on this. Now you have your current users and potential users. There are no users in my cohort, zero users. So I will select a potential user and add it to my cohort. I'll select again and add them to the cohort. So I say user one and user three will be a part of this cohort. Click on back to cohorts. Now you see the cohort size is 2. Morning batch cohort size 2. Because I have added 2 users to this cohort. If you want to see what all users are present in this cohort, you can again click on this. Right? Yes, sir, you will be able to see the admin user everywhere because the admin user is also a user. So it can be a scenario where not just students, you also want to have a course creator or a teacher as a part of a cohort, or even the site administrator as a part of a cohort. Everything is a user account at the end. What matters are the privileges using which it can fiddle with other accounts, create other accounts, or change other accounts. So all this information that I'm trying to share with you, I have logged in from a site administrator account. When a student will log in from a student privilege, he or she will not be able to view this information. So this is about cohorts, how you create cohorts, and how you add students to the cohorts. Move back to site administration.
The same procedure, madam.
Sorry?
Ma'am, your screen
removing the user from your cohort.
Your voice is getting mixed.
Your screen is not coming properly, ma'am.
Sir, I'm sharing. According to my system, it is there.
Removing a user from your cohort.
Right. So if you want to remove a user from a cohort, then go back to cohorts. Go back to this assign.
Where is the assign, ma'am?
This one. People icon is there, na? In cohorts.
I'm not able to see that, ma'am. What happening in my...
Are you able to see my screen?
Hello. Yes, ma'am.
Are you able to see my screen, sir?
Yes.
Yeah. So we were at site administration.
Yes.
Users.
Yes.
Cohorts. You see this option here? Third last?
Yes.
Click on it.
Yes, ma'am.
Were you able to create a cohort?
I'm able to create, but due to this, I have to type I'm to start my this Moodle, man, localhost?
Localhost / Moodle.
Just a minute. You continue, ma'am, I will do it. You don't worry.
So here in this assign icon.
Oh, that was this machar was not able to.
Yes.
I was not able to see that machar.
Very, very small icon in the end, this one, assign.
Ma'am, can you hold for 10 seconds? I am just doing very fast.
Sir, I'm holding. No problem. We can even extend beyond time.
Removing user from the cohort will won't entirely remove the user from the users
select
list, right?
Select the user from current users and press remove.
So it means that screen. Only from the cohort, it will be removing the users, right? Not so from the...
No, that is the logical sense, ma'am. You are adding users to a cohort and removing from cohort. You're not bothered about potential users. You're not deleting users from the system here.
Hello, ma'am.
In this, so we get the four icons.
I'll go back for you just a minute.
So that pupil icon, I have read. Okay, you are getting straight four icons, and in my screen, it is getting two. So okay. Now it is, I have to assign it.
Yes, assign.
Okay.
All potential users will be coming to your right.
Yes.
And all current users will be in this.
Hello, I'm not. Just I'm not getting the option of size.
Just a minute. Let me complete with this query. Yes, sir.
Current user, I don't know. There is no current user is coming in.
Perfectly,
my...
perfectly. Because you have not added any user to the current user. Select a user from potential. Click on it. And add to this. When you add, it will come to current users. Is it, sir?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Now you go back, sir. Your cohort size will be 1.
So I have to go back.
Go back to cohorts. Just press on the back button. Shall I walk you through from the beginning? How to reach to the screen.
But ma'am, it my screen it is showing still 0.
Did it add users to the cohort? Click on that assign option again and see.
Ma'am, now I'm not doing it and I am seeing your how do you performing the function.
Okay, sir. As if your users have been successfully assigned to your cohort, they will come in this panel. So you have to simply select a user from potential, add. Click on add button.
That I did, or one user came to my that. Then after that, what to do?
Here beneath, on the left side, you have back to cohorts. This button.
Oh.
On the screen only, sir. Scroll down.
Instead of when you say na, to press the back button, so I press that arrow button, back arrow button. That is why I think this problem is coming.
Never mind, sir. It will lead you to the previous page and session is not properly maintained in Moodle. That's fine. Move to back to cohorts. Now your cohort size has increased.
Ah, yes, it is. One is coming.
Perfect, sir. Yes, Prajna ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Yes, Prajna, ma'am, may I help you?
I did it.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, just can we add here bulk cohorts?
Bulk user.
In bulk.
You have to select an ad. Yeah. You have to select an ad from a sign.
So, ma'am,
So if a number is more, like 100 and all, it will be very difficult.
You can multiple select, like press on a user, select a user, press control key and select another user.
No, it's okay. Here we have only 2. Okay, so no, absolutely no problem. Suppose we have 150 students.
That is what I'm telling you. You have to perform multiple selection.
Okay.
You have to multiple
select. That can be done using bulk interactions. There is one option, add to cohort, no? I have seen.
That is upload cohort.
Upload
users are already present in the system, but if the users are already present in your system, you have to only add them to a cohort. You can't recreate them.
Pardon, I didn't get.
If you've created all users and then you have to assign them to cohort, So this is the only option. Upload cohort will ask you to upload users also. Upload users and add them to cohort. That's not feasible because you already have users in your system.
So ma'am, when these three users,
I think bulk user action, it's possible to upload bulk users through add to cohort options.
That is also the same thing, ma'am. There also you are adding in selection. This is what you're saying. See, site administration, just a minute, give me a second. Users, bulk user action. You are saying I want to add users first to the selection and then from here I want to say add to cohort. Here also you are performing the same thing. You are bringing existing users to selection. That is what I'm saying. If ma'am says I have multiple users and say if 100 or 200 users I want to add to one cohort and then I want to add other 200 users to another cohort. So how is that possible? If you will do an add all selection here, it will add all 400 users to selection. That is not desired. I want to make two cohorts. So in that case also you have to do a multiple select, as I said, press control, do a multi select and then add to selection. Same process as in cohorts.
Ma'am, if these are the two boxes and I have 100 users and out of 100 users, the list of the persons whom I want to select from this to batch one is not in a sequential manner.
Okay.
So how I can select this? Because if I will say select all, then it will select all. I want to cut out or remaining out some people in between. So what to do?
Then you have to make usernames like that, you know, append probably a number ahead of it.
So you have to make it in a sequential way.
Yeah, make it and upload it in a sequential way. The order in which you upload will be the order in which they come in this.
So there is no user account. There is no option of deselection and selection.
No. So deselection and selection is if you have selected all.
That means either you are selecting all or deselecting all.
No, you can select, like I want to select 1 and 3. I can do this also. This is what I was telling, that first click on 3, then press control and click on 1.
Oh.
Click on 1, press control, click on 3.
Okay. So that can be done when you are adding some few people.
Right.
But if you are adding more than 50 people, then you cannot do control 1, 3, 5, 7, something like that. That is not feasible at all.
Then, sir, you have to be either you add the users and create the cohort at that time, upload cohort option, which I said. Otherwise, you have to do the selection thing only if your users have already created.
So you have to be taken care, you have to be very careful while creating the user.
Yes, and, sir. This is one of the most critical parts of this Moodle
MS. So the right way is to you create in a sequential way in which cohort you want to add in.
Right. And upload at the same time and put them in a cohort. Be very, very careful when you are creating users, because once created, they run for the entire duration of the Moodle MS. So this is a very critical section that we are discussing today. One last portion that is left in my demonstration, which I'd like to cover before I take up more doubts. Site administration, users. Now we've created...
Ma'am, yes. Just hold on. Let us also do site.
Okay.
Site users. Administration.
Users.
Ma'am, is in this window, the user is the most important part?
This is a window for users, sir. There are other parts as well, plugins, grades, courses, but users are a very sensitive section of Moodle.
So, and when in the second line, they are showing some server reports. So, you will discuss these all things or not?
We will be discussing, sir, certain advanced features in the later or last sections of Moodle. Will be discussed by Uttam, sir. So there will be giving a brief of these sections, but plugins and all we'll be discussing in detail.
So what plugins and?
Plugins and external database connectivity, such advanced topics we'll be discussing in detail Rest in the later, like Friday and Thursday session, they'll be giving you an idea of the advanced features also.
Well, where is that extra? You told me extra or some extra. What is extra?
Sir, I don't remember what I say. I speak very spontaneously. I don't write it.
Ma'am, because you plugins is there and you said another word also.
Advanced features, external database connectivity.
So where it is? It is not.
Next session. Not. In the next session. It is mentioned.
But right now it is not coming.
In your program schedule?
No, I'm just saying that on this visible screen, which
is... No, it will not come here, sir. There is a different way to do it. That's basically a very technical coding part, which Uttam sir will discuss in the next session. Not on this screen.
अरे मैडम काय को डिफिकल्ट पार्ट की तरफ ले जा रहे हो, कुछ अच्छे छोटी छोटी बातें बता के ए प्लस सर्टिफिकेट देगा, छुट्टी करो ना अभी, इस उम्र में काय तंग कर रहे हो।
मेरे हाथ में नहीं है सर सब कुछ, मैं सिर्फ अपना पार्ट बता सकती हूँ। यस सर, सो प्लीज लेट मी कंप्लीट दिस पोर्शन।
सो गो टू यूजर्स एंड देन
या
हेलो
मैम, कैन यू टेक द डाउट्स टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द सेशन प्लीज?
या
आई टेक ऑल डाउट्स टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द सेशन। आई हैव टू कंप्लीट वन सेक्शन फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ एवरीबॉडी हू इज अटेंडिंग। सम हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड वे बैक एंड आर वेटिंग फॉर दैट सेक्शन। इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल असाइनमेंट। आफ्टर दैट यू कैन टेक, आई टेक योर डाउट्स अप टिल 4 और इवन बियॉन्ड, नो प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर कोऑपरेशन। द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस एफडीपी इज assign system roles. So click on assign system roles. You see here the two roles that I was talking of, manager and course creator. These are the two roles that you can assign to users which are already present in your system. So right now there are zero managers and zero course creators. Apart from these two roles, the other two roles of a teacher and a student, they will only come into play when you enroll those users into a course. So that is a part of course enrollment, which will be covered by Uttam sir 4 p.m. onwards. I'll just teach you how to create a manager and how to create a course creator.
Remember, also, how reach this screen? My side has been administration.
Sir, permissions, within the permissions section, there is assign system roles.
Side administration and then
users.
I select user.
Assign system roles.
There is a assign system role is there, something. Permission. Go to permission.
Sir, assign system roles here. I'm pointing my mouse towards it.
Assign user roles to assign. This is not coming in my.
You're using the cloud version, sir?
No.
Users.
I have to go to
permission section.
I have to go to permission section.
Scroll down. Scroll down, sir. We were here at accounts. We were doing upload users and all.
I'm sorry. Not getting it. Go to site administration, then go to users.
Users.
I go to users. And now I have to go where?
Assign system roles.
In under which category?
Permission, sir.
Assign user roles to cohort.
I have covered bulk cohort. There is nothing that I have not covered and you're accusing me of. Whoever is writing in the chat window, I have mentioned how is it to be completed. But I have to take every participant with me and move. Otherwise, it will not be the best interest of all. Please bear with me for 5 minutes.
Okay, ma'am. I got it. Assign role in system.
Yes. Assign system roles.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Sorry, I'm just a little bit lazy people.
But sir. No, sir. Somebody in the chat box is writing for that. I'm saying. In the manager part, click on manager.
Click on manager.
Now, if you want to add a user to a manager privilege, I'm assigning privileges here, I'm not creating users. So if I want say user one to be my manager, click on user one, add to this section. Right. Go back. system. You have to move back through the proper process. It does not maintain state in move. Check assign system roles again. Now I have one manager that I've created here. Right. Similarly, if you want to create a course creator, the role that we discussed in theory, I say user 2 to be my course creator. Click on user 2, add. Simply, it will be added as a course creator. If you want to see whether the change persisted or not, move to site administration, users, then assign system roles. Now I have one manager and one course creator that I added. I'm simply assigning roles. This is the simplest part. Creating user was very difficult. Assigning a user role was very simple. Next, if you want to see what the system role means, and if I want to change the meaning of any system roles, you see define system roles, define roles. So here is a description of every role that you have, a manager role, a course creator, teacher, non-editing teacher, student, guest, what do they mean? What is the short name? And if you want to edit privilege, so if you want to edit privilege for any role, this will only be possible if you are the site administrator. If you're using the cloud account, some things may vary for you. So editing a manager role, short name, context types, allow role, switches, overrides. If I want to change any permission setting for any role, I can do that using this panel. So this came from defined roles. So this is where it will give you a brief listing of what roles are, what privileges are associated with those roles, and you can create a manager and a course creator role directly from site administration. Now, if you want to create a teacher or probably change, I'm not saying create, I'll say if you want to change anything related to a teacher role, then you can change that role settings also from this panel. But if you want to enroll a teacher to a course or a student to a course, then you have to do that in the course option. That will be discussed with Uttam sir in the next lecture.
So by default, a teacher is a course creator, right? Or can we define a different role?
If you want to see that, sir, defined roles, we'll see for a teacher. And it has certain privileges associated with it. What it can do and what it cannot. If you want, it can, if you want to see a brief of what the role means, it's mentioned here. It can even change assignment activities, grading options, it can generate analytics, but a course creator will only create new courses. It does not have these other functionalities which a teacher has. And if you want to change these settings for a teacher, you can do that inside this role as a site administrator. You can select certain options, you can uncheck certain privileges, you can do that. A teacher can do anything within a course, including changing the activities and grading students. But a course creator will only create new courses. That's it. We'll see for the course creator also. A lesser privileged role than a teacher. Lesser functionalities that a course creator can perform, but you can always increase it as a site administrator. You can give your own settings to things. So in the site administration panel, you can create users and you can define roles. You can also associate a teacher or, a manager or a course creator roles. Let's see what site administrator does. There is only one site administrator here in your main panel, and this will only be visible to those who are site administrators. Those who are using the account with manager privileges will not be able to see this. Managing site administrators is only possible if you log in using the site administration. ठीक है. जस्ट देर आर मोर ऑप्शन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी फॉर प्राइवेसी सेटिंग्स डेटा रिक्वेस्ट डिलीशन. सो दिस पेज इज देयर विद फर्दर मोर ऑप्शन. If you have any doubts, please let me know. The demonstration from my side is done.
Demonstration is over, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
So, ma'am,
just show me once again how you edited it.
What, the manager and the course creator,
yeah,
ma'am?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So, in the user section, permissions tab, I have assigned system roles. This is where when I click on manager, all potential users listed here and all existing users listed here. If I want to add a potential user as a manager to a course, I can do that. Simply select the account and bring it to the selected panel. If you want to see the change, don't go with the back option. This will not give you the correct result. Move again to site administration, users, assign system roles. Now I see two managers there. Similarly, you can assign course creators as well.
So here
what about the define roles? In the define roles
will just tell you what privileges a manager has, what a manager can usually do.
Go to the settings.
Right.
Settings. Got it. Thank you.
So, ma'am, we can create only from this option only manager and course creator.
Yes, sir.
So, rest were student or teachers?
That Uttam sir will discuss in the next lecture. They enroll in a course.
Okay, ma'am.
Because here, these managers and course creators will be, sir, unanimous for the entire system. They will be a part of the entire site. That is why they are in the site administration part. But the teacher and a student will be specific to a course. So that is why they are called as course enrollments.
So that means that this Moodle system doesn't provide much flexibility for in the hand of teachers and students.
No, you can restrict completely as a site administrator. Complete privileges only with the site administrator. I can make those roles as restrictive as I want. I can even make a teacher not edit content in the course. Only the course creator can. I can do that also.
Okay. So after site administration, the other two powerful are manager and course creator.
Yes.
And madam, what is about that co-administrator? How we will create co-administrator?
Co-administrator, manager, sir. A manager is a lesser defined privilege for a site administrator.
So it is the subhead. It is the subhead of administrator.
Site administrator.
Okay. So that means you have one boss is admin and then the two bosses are course creator and manager.
Right.
And man, out of manager and course creator, who is the most much powerful?
Manager.
So manager can restrict it to some, how to course creator?
Manager has certain privileges with other users also, but a course creator will only have maximum privileges with the course content and course creation.
I am just asking that what facility is given to creator. If manager want to restrict him, so he can restrict it?
Yeah, you can.
Sure?
Yes, sir. You all are logging in from the manager privilege. You can create your course creators.
Okay, no, because you were just replying me in a little
bit. I'm thinking.
Okay. No problem, ma'am. Nobody is the master. Everyone is the learner. Either you or me or even the...
Definitely. I'm also pretty new to the system.
I cannot raise query on your or doubt on your capability and knowledge.
I'm not saying that I'm a complete expert. I'm also gradually learning with the process. Yes. And every FDP, I learn something new.
Definitely, ma'am. Definitely. Yeah. And ma'am, you are taking a class in such a very good way and very cool way, and your temperament is an excellent. You are replying each and every student like student me, who is always asking you so many queries, but still that's great. God bless you, ma'am. God bless you.
I'm also a student like you, sir, for my teachers. It's the same thing, just different roles. sometimes site administrator, sometimes student.
So ma'am, अभी 5 सितंबर गया है तो आपको नमस्कार प्रणाम मैम.
Sir, thank you sir and wish you to a very happy belated teachers day.
Thank you ma'am. Thank you ma'am. Ma'am, just one thing. I just want to know last question of this session.
Sure, sir.
If after this class, can I want to contact you? I can contact you.
Yes, sir. I'll get in touch with you.
So how I will contact you?
I'll get in touch with you, sir. I'll call
okay. you. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. You have my number.
I'll get it, sir, from the group.
Ma'am, just please do call me after 6, please.
Sure, sir. I will call you.
God bless you, ma'am. Thank you very Thank much. You, and I am taking off from this class now.
Sure. Okay. Sir. If there are no other queries, we can close the session and meet at 4.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much for such a nice and wonderful session. And ma'am, just last query.
2 more, sir. 10 more.
Ma'am, that you were saying here that you will connect to that teacher who is in charge of assignment. So when you will connect to me?
Sir, she's present on the WhatsApp group. I will just drop in a message there. You can raise your queries with assignment.
So what I have to do, go through WhatsApp or can I directly contact her?
Sir, both she's available on WhatsApp also, you can call her also.
Yeah, Tanya.
Yes, sir.
Excellent session.
Thank you, sir.
And dear participants, whatever queries you have, we have made official WhatsApp group. So you can keep posting queries on official WhatsApp group. Do not hesitate that this is alone your query. It must be the queries of many other participants as well who might not be asking that. So the only problem is many queries irritate few participants. But as we have joined the program, when we instructors are not getting irritated, my request to all the participants, you also should not get irritated. If it is of your use, use it. If it is of not your use, you can ignore it. So queries related to assignment, queries related to any confusion in this session, you are most welcome to raise in WhatsApp group. And concerned team members, all the three inspectors, Dr. Ritika Vasan, who looks after the assignment aspect, then Mr. Manish, who is looking after your assessment aspect, means your MCQ test, your attendance and your final grading, all these members are part of the same WhatsApp group. So whosoever is posting their query, the concerned member will reply. It might be possible that every member may not be having all information, but the concerned member might be having. So the concerned member will reply you back. And we try to reply at the earliest possible, that we will do, right? If no reply is coming, I am also part of that group. If no reply is coming in a time-bound manner, then I intervene. So I don't think there is any confusion in that. And with respect to overall lecture, my request to all the participants will be that we should follow abstraction policy. That if everything, every participant expect in the same lecture, then what for other lectures have been planned? Different lectures have been planned having different purposes, and all those input that in which lecture what will be taught, including the slides to be discussed in that particular lecture, have been shared with you in advance. So please go through that. And if you feel that there is anything which we are not going to discuss, and then you want to discuss, let me know that. That I will see to that how best we can accommodate. At the time of designing this program, we have done huge brainstorming. And this is the third program and Moodle which is going on. So after that brainstorming, we realized that it is not possible to teach everything of Moodle. It is such an exhaustive learning management system. But nonetheless, at least such basic features, such bare minimum facilities must be discussed with the participants, so that those who have got better interest, those who wanted to make themselves as a more proficient user, administrator, manager of Moodle, they can explore it further. That the understanding that this entire program has been designed. So that I wanted to give you a little input. Thank you so much. Now let's close this session to join back a little early so that we can start at 4 p.m. sharp. Right.